know, it all started in probably primary school. I think it was about like in standard 5, grade 7, I think it was another year before that. And there was this this disco after school disco in the school hall, and it was on a Friday afternoon, and so they were playing this music in the hall, and like somehow suddenly there was this big circle in the hall, and like a lot of kids scattered around this circle, and so I also wanted to see what's happening in the circle, you know. And so when they there was two guys battling each other, doing backspins and stuff, and just a whole lot of spinning stuff, you know, that caught my eye. And I stood there for a couple of minutes and just focused, yo, what's going on here, you know. And I just felt attracted to this thing that's going on here now. And I'm looking at it, and I'm so amazed to see what it is. And you know, when you see something and you know that this is where I belong, this is where I fit in. And yeah, but I never got the chance to speak to these guys and to ask them what is this that they're doing. And as time went on, as I went to high school, yeah, and in my class there was a couple of guys who did b-boying as well. And they could only do a couple of moves, at intervals I'll see them in the corridors and they'll break it down doing some stuff. And then, so this one day I just decided to join in and see what I can do. And so I just grew with that, and I started breaking. And there was 2 months after that, some girl came to the school and she wanted to do auditions for guys who want to dance. That's what they said on the intercom. Like I said, I went down to all of the school, and but when I saw that, auditions for guys who could already dance, you know. So this wasn't my place, because I thought they're going to teach you to dance at that time. And I had audition, and I tried out what I can do, but I didn't make it to the final selection. And yeah, so after school I was still interested in this dance. I want to see more, I want to see where this is leading to. And I just went to practice, and the source of the wall. And somehow this group, they needed somebody to do something specific in this show, and I could do that. You know, and I asked somebody who's sitting here, can you do this thing that they're looking for? And I just, I put a man and said, I can do this. And so that from that time, I just got into the show, and I asked, they used me to do this specific move to do it. And after that, just, and I felt I actually belong here now. I started out with a group called Tornadoes. This was the group that they auditioned for. And then after that, yeah, it didn't really go that far. We were dancing together for I think maximum 2 years. So everybody just took off in their own direction, looking for, I know, probably better things, you know. And me and Shaw, just me and Shaw, we stayed in the same area. And other smaller ones that was under us, who trained with us. So we started the group. And from there, I met Dimitri, people meeting. And we got together, started a new team called Plate Breakers, and then from there we gave it to the smaller guys, and then we started a crew called Handbreaker, which included Ramon from POC, myself, Dimitri, Vivo Viti, Shaw, MC, Bluxum Strel, Vivo Roots. That was the guys, and there was another guy called Rian from Kills River, but he passed away in 2006, Penny from Immortal Star was also in the group. And we had this, it was like a small super crew that we made up. And from there, years went on, and a lot of guys just left the group as well. Till this day, it's just me, Dimitri, and Shaw, still keeping the crew going. And I'm also part of Praswani Cup as well. And Concrete Apostles is a new team that we created for to go out internationally and battle international competitions to put South Africa back on the map, so that they can see there's actually more guys in South Africa that's doing this thing and want to keep it alive. And then a couple of months ago, we created this new group called Ninja Turtles, because we wanted to enter this. This group Ninja Turtles started from a theater show that we created through Hildehood and the British Council called Mixing It Up, where we use the traditional South African dancing, kambos, mansula, Zulu dancing, punswa, Nama dance, like a whole lot of different stuff, like in animal movements and stuff, and we incorporated this with breaking and hip hop, and just try to create something like identity for South African hip hop. Project E does a whole lot of stuff, you know, like from doing workshops to community, park jams, going up, teaching kids. We recently applied for a space at the multi-purpose center in East River, the new center that opened. So we got kids there afternoon coming in, we teach them, and we also go out to areas and just set up speakers and just give a lot of kids just a place to just to have fun. We put down our practice boards and we just dance with them, and we just try and if you're doing nothing on a day, like I would say, like there's a lot of kids that doesn't come out to see a lot of stuff, so we just try to take it to them. Because a lot of people, they will say, yeah, we just see you on TV and magazines, but you never see you doing the stuff really, you know. So we just thought, okay, cool, why not? And just Project E is also just like a platform for our people in East River to get noticed, you know, under one name, you know. So when we go out, we represent our area where we come from. Basically, I would say first thing, the music. Because I grew up in a house where music was played every day. My uncle stayed with us when I was still in primary school, and he used to play this Tupac every morning. You literally wake up to hip hop music, you know, and it's almost like I never had the choice to listen to other music, but it's just this music was constantly playing, and I just grew with this, and from there, I saw music videos and a whole lot of stuff, because there was a lot of stuff on TV as well that influenced me to take part in hip hop. I felt like this is what, I would say ghetto is, and this is where all of this stuff is happening. And I mean, I'm from the ghetto, and I wouldn't say ghetto, but I mean classified as the ghetto, I would say, yeah, that's the ghetto. And I mean, this is something that we created, and this is my people doing this thing. And I mean, I perfectly fit in what was going on now. And when I look at dancing, I would say I got the freedom to do whatever I want to do. You know, when I hit the dance floor, I just do what is me, you know. When I listen to the music, obviously, but besides, there's a deeper thing that's going on when you're on the dance floor, when you go. It's just, you know, everything just bursts out of you. You just want to be free and do, if you want to roll that side on that side, you're free to do that. There's no limit. I think there's no limit in hip hop, really, you know, but especially in dancing, you can do whatever the hell you want to do when you hit the dance floor. And I really feel comfortable with that, and this is where I'm at, and this is where I want to be, probably for my whole life, if it can continue like that.